Hello everyone, thanks for coming to the Drupal Meetup. This is going to be about presenting media in Drupal. I did give this talk, or part of this talk, at the Drupal Dallas days, but just for those of you who have already seen that video online, or for those of you who went to Drupal Dallas days, I will be going into some other stuff for this presentation, just to kind of build on top of what I was presenting last time, but then also I'd like to touch into what's coming in the future. My name is Travis Tidwell. I work for allplayers.com. I'm one of the lead developers there. And just to kind of just give a little bit about AllPlayers, we build a service website that offers, you know, free group management for people that want to organize, any type of group activity, whether you're a family, whether you're a sports organization. It's just a way to manage group activities. My profile is 98581. I'm also known as just Travis T. That's my nick on Drupal.org. And here we go. Let's go ahead and get started. So what I'm going to be talking about today is primarily media, multimedia in Drupal, which this has kind of been a topic that has been talked about. It's been fraught over for many, many years. In fact, as long as I've been involved in Drupal, which has been roughly over 5 years now that I've been involved with Drupal. And ever since I've been involved, I've kind of had this passion for working with multimedia, just because it's something that I consider it challenging, and it's also hard to find the right solution. And so I've spent a lot of time investigating and working with different use cases and different people and different clients, and trying to build and collect what I consider just a really good solution for presenting media to your users. So the first thing I want to talk about is actually media management. Then I'm going to go into media presentation, followed with a little bit of a discussion on HTML5 and what that brings to multimedia. And then I'm going to give a demo of MediaFront. And then also I'm going to discuss what I'm currently working on for putting multimedia support, finally putting multimedia support into Drupal Core. So that's what we're going to be talking about. Last time I presented, I did spend way too much time on the presentation part, and I didn't give enough time with the actual walkthrough. So if I seem to be going really fast in the presentation, keep in mind that I am recording this. So this will be available online that you guys can watch a little bit later. And of course, you guys can ask questions at will. You know, there's really no rules as far as when to ask questions. So if I'm not clear with something, please feel free to raise your hand. So let's talk a little bit about integrating media. So if you're here, you at least have somewhat of an interest that you want to be able to integrate media into your Drupal site. You want to be able to show multimedia to your users. This interests you. Well, if this is you, you actually have two things that you need to worry about. The first one is, how do you want to manage your media? And the second item is, how do you want to present your media? And the big point that I want to make here is that we have to make a clear definition between the two. There's been a lot of multimedia solutions out there that kind of try to combine the presentation layer with the actual management layer, and it's just kind of just been a nightmare. So what I'd really like to talk about is just the different ways that not only you can manage your media, but then also talk about ways that you can present your media, which as far as I'm concerned is something that's been neglected for many, many years in Drupal. It's like just the presentation layer of media. So let's talk about managing media. Out of the box, Drupal 7 is pretty good at managing multimedia, just because it's able to manage files. If you think about what is multimedia, well, media is simply a file. That's really all it is. And so if you are able to have a good way to manage files, there is no reason why you should not have a good way to also manage. This is doing automatic, isn't it? There should be no way, there should be an easy way for you to also manage media. And so out of the box, Drupal 7 comes with the file field, where you can create a field, as you can see with this image that I have here, where you can create a field, you can upload, and you can also create an image upload. And for this, these are just simple file fields, and these are image fields. These are out of the box in Drupal, which does okay. But for the most people out there, you're going to want something a little bit more flexible. And in fact, I can't really think of any use case where you would not want more flexibility out of your media management. And the module that really shines here, and something that I want to highlight to start off this presentation, is the media module. Now, there's just been a huge initiative in the Drupal community to build like this media management solution all wrapped up into this one module called the media module. It is absolutely fantastic in what they've done. And one thing I do want to stress is most of their concern is with managing media. How do you want to manage media? Well, just to give you some highlights on the media module, it defines entities for each media type, video, audio, and image. Image is by default defined in Drupal. It offers third-party integration, which by downloading just a separate module, you can bring in YouTube, Vimeo. It utilizes stream wrappers for managing both public and remote files. So like if you have files on the S3 or like the Amazon, any of those type of servers, you can use those. And it also includes this intuitive media browser, which I'm going to kind of highlight a little bit today, that has this concept of a media library, where you can share media and other entities with other entities in your system. So this I consider just a huge leap, because before we had media module, if you wanted to show media, you would have to upload a file to a node, and then there was really no way to share that with other nodes. I mean, there were some solutions out there that allowed you to do it. But the media module really tackled this problem and did it really well, because they offered this library. I'll show you here in just a little bit. So the first thing is just the media upload. So this right here is what they call the media browser. So when you upload media, you're presented with this. You're going to see this whenever I do the demo walkthrough, where you can upload a file. You can select if you want to link to a video within the web. So these are from plugins where you can use YouTube. I don't know why there's two YouTube there, but then here's Vimeo and YouTube, and you can actually paste the URL. And then what I consider just awesome is this library, where after you've uploaded a media to your system, the media module keeps track of this library of media that you have. So you can pull in the same media into other types of nodes on your system, which is just really cool. I'll show all of this when I do the demo walkthrough. And then it also offers a way to manage media just like you would manage content. So if you actually go to administer content on your Drupal 7 site, you get this media tab, which shows all the multimedia on your site, which is just really cool, because then it's kind of offering multimedia as it would just offer normal content, which is just, it's really great. So that's primarily the guts of how you would want to manage your media. Again, I'm going to go in more detail when I do the walkthrough. But what this presentation is primarily over is something that I feel has been kind of neglected, which is how do we want to present our multimedia? Up until now, there's been just a plethora of different solutions. There's all these different kinds of modules that you can install, where you might have to go out and download a Flash player, and you might have to pay a license fee, or you might have to do something just to get a display of your media on your website. And so what I'd like to present is that's no longer the case. One thing I do want to point out is how you present your media is really critical if you want to offer multimedia on your site. It's something that you have to think of right from the very get-go if you're starting a multimedia website. A lot of times, media presentation is an afterthought. And to me, this is so annoying, because you'll see this really well-built website, and they don't think about media presentation until the very end. So what you end up with is like the default YouTube player on like these really awesome websites, and they just because they don't think about it. They don't think of, you know, how do we want to present this media to, you know, coincide with our presentation layer. Another thing you need to think about is that each browser is different in how they implement and how they present media. So this is something that's just been a major headache for anybody that wants to offer multimedia. So at first we had Flash to solve this problem. So whenever I actually got involved with multimedia was whenever Flash was just now becoming mainstream to present media. So I got involved with multimedia in Drupal even before YouTube was around, which was 2006. And if you guys remember, YouTube kind of just paved the way for using Flash to present multimedia. Up until that point, it was just kind of, you know, everybody would upload whatever multimedia format that browser supported. So if you were wanting to show it with Internet Explorer, you would use MWV file. Or if you wanted to show it in Safari, you would use an MOV file. So we would use these different formats for these different browsers. Well, Flash came around and it was great. It offered a standardized single solution. All you had to do is encode your videos into a single format and it would display great. So that was awesome. So the only problem, and everyone knows, with Flash, it is a proprietary plugin. You know, we want to move on. We want to get our standards up to a point where we no longer need our users to download this third-party plugin just to show media. So now we have HTML5 for that. And it was supposed to fix this problem. That was the intent. But as I'm going to describe, the people who actually implemented made some really, really critical mistakes as far as I'm concerned, which they standardized. They did a great job standardizing the elements, but what they didn't standardize was the codecs, which kind of, I'll explain it. So let's talk a little bit about HTML5. So HTML5 defines, it defines so many more elements than this, but the ones that we're going to be interested in is video and audio, which works a lot like the image tag. So if you're familiar with using image tag, you can use a video tag in an HTML5 browser. So you just simply say video source, my video MP4, and it'll show the video, audio, my audio MP3, and man, I wish it was that simple. But as you will discover, it is far from being that simple. And what I'm gonna talk about is that right now. So each browser implements this differently. And here's what you get. You get this little chart, which I got from Wikipedia, which shows which browsers support what codecs and if they support it or if you have to manually install it. So you get kind of this, you see a lot of green here, but the problem is if unless you see all green, you can't trust it. And so we have this real big problem because the W3C committee they did not standardize the codec. And so all these browsers are like, I'm going to implement H.264, and this browser, another browser says, no, I'm going to do AUG. And so all your users use different browsers, and there's really no way to manage that. Not only that, but every browser looks different. So you have the Chromes, you have I've even forgotten what they are. So you have like Safari, and you have Firefox over here. Regardless, every browser looks different. So this is okay, except if you have a standardized template. You know, like if you want to present a standardized presentation layer of your multimedia, you can't have browsers that totally don't match your overall look and feel of your website. So this is a really big problem. So as far as I'm concerned, we are back where we started before we had Flash. In fact, we're in no better position right now than when we did have Flash. You have to think about the browser and upload media for that browser. And so it's really caused a big headache. And so what I'm here to present is just a solution to this problem, or a potential solution to this problem, which is a module that I wrote. And my objective was to wrap up all of these inconsistencies with these browsers into a single module. And so what I'm really doing is I'm trying to present this thing as a front-end presentation layer for multimedia. I'm not trying to accomplish anything more than that. If you guys are wanting to find a module that will convert videos for you, or if it's going to manage your videos for you, this is not what I'm concerned with. What I'm concerned with is simply presentation layer. So let me just give you some high-level selling points of what this module is. First of all, it's written in jQuery. It does have automatic Flash fallback for non-supporting browsers, integration with third parties such as YouTube and Vimeo, which I'll demonstrate all of this. It integrates with views to deliver dynamic playlists. It's themable using the Drupal theme system, which I think a lot of people take that for granted, that you know there's really no media players out there except this one that is actually built using the Drupal theme system. Consistent user interface across all browsers. So there's the projects right here. You can go to the project page, which is MediaFront, or you can go to MediaFront.org. And also, this was also featured on Twit TV's Floss Weekly. If anybody watches that show, I was able to present and give a presentation over it. So now it's time to give this demo. And what I feel like I did wrong last time I did this is I kind of just like jumped in to where the site was already built. And so a lot of times you get this where a presenter's like, okay, so we're going to start from here. Well, it's like just to get to this point is so difficult. So what I've actually done is I've created what's called a make file. And who else is familiar with the Drupal make file? I know you guys are. Put your hands down. So anyway, what a make file is, huh?
Is it a compilation script?
Yeah, it's a lot like a compilation script. It's like a bundle script. But really all you have to concern yourself with is installing Drush, is really what you need to install, is get Drush on your system. From there, where you want to go is you want to go to this site right here, which is github.com / Travis T, and then it's called MediaFront Demo. What's really cool about this is this, all you have to do is type, once you get Drush installed, all you do is type Drush make MediaFront make, and that will literally build this Drupal install for you. You'll see it download
fresh
all the modules.
Fresh install?
Huh?
Fresh install.
If you want me to, I can do it actually if you want to. I'll do it later. Let me do the presentation. I'll walk through the make in a little while. But that's all you do is type MediaFront make. So that'll get you to where I am at the beginning of the presentation. I also created another make where if you type this, it'll build a site that's going to look like after I'm done with this presentation, which all the media is going to be set up and it's going to be wicked cool. So, and then after that, all you have to do is type Drush enable media feature. What that does is it builds the media feature for you. It installs all these modules and it creates the media content types. It does everything for you. And then if you want test content, this is something that's new. I have a module where you just say Drush enable media content. And literally this is what you end up with. Just to give you an example, like I can just go ahead and delete this database, which typically, I mean, people would be like, no, don't do that. You spent so much time setting this up. I'm just going to delete these tables and walk through what it will look like. This is what it will look like if you actually first install it. You're going to set up the installer. Here I am setting up a brand new Drupal install. So this is like what you see when you first set this up. So here we go. Save and continue. I didn't have to configure my database configurations. Here it's installing the Drupal install. So this is actually going to build what you just saw for you. And then I just have to walk through some configurations. This will not take long at all. You'll see in about 2 minutes, I'm going to have...
Password is password?
Yeah. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. It's the same password in my screen case. All right. So anyway, this is actually going to install my Drupal install. And then after this is done, which it should be finished here pretty soon. It's always the case. You always have in demo time. Demo time, nothing seems to work right. So here we are. This is what it looks like whenever you first install Drupal, right? Everyone's seen this, Drupal 7. Now check this out. All I'm going to do, so here I am. I'm in MediaFront demo. Type Drush enable MediaFront or media feature. For some reason, Drush fails the first time I do it. If anybody would like to look into that for me, that'd be great. But the second time I do it, it works. I don't know. I don't know why.
It looks like a cache thing.
It must be. I don't know. I don't know what's going on.
PC running or something?
No.
I don't see a lot.
And then if I install that, you'll see nothing really shows up. In fact, you're like, okay, that's great. But one thing you will notice is that you can add content now, and you see the media. HTML5 media, which I'll cover here in a little bit when I talk about what's coming for Drupal 8. But now, check this out, media content. And what this is going to do, this is going to pre-populate all of that content that you saw, media. So it's building nodes, and it's bringing in media from YouTube, and it's doing all kinds of cool stuff. It's bringing in posters from IMDb. So, you know, a lot of times this would take you like an hour just to get set up so you can test it. What I'm doing for you guys is just you can go right away and get to where you are in this presentation. So this is something that new that I've developed. Yep.
If you disable media content, will it remove it?
No, I haven't done that yet. But what you can do though is you can just delete it. Go to your manage content and delete it.
Have you looked at the default content module?
I haven't. I should look at that. Default content module?
Yes.
Yeah, I'll take a look. And for some reason, it's running a lot slower than it normally does. A lot of time, I think it's because I've got like screen sharing going, and I've got all kinds of crazy stuff going right now. But what this is doing is actually building content for me.
How much?
Like just 12 nodes. I mean, it's not like crazy. I don't know why it's getting hung up. Oh, I know why. It's probably bringing in
the actual videos.
It's probably no, it's not bringing in the videos. It's probably bringing in the IMDb images. So when I in my internet connection, of course, you know your internet connection sucks, but
it well, it's a clear.
You know what I might do?
Is it starting to populate? Or can we?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can see. We can see if it's starting to populate.
Hey. Yeah.
It's doing something. So, okay, so while it's populating, I can go ahead and walk through my demos. So regardless, this thing is going to sit there and it's going to build like these images, which is pretty cool because you got something to play with. So the first thing that I want to demonstrate is what you might get without any type of media presentation. So out of the box, Drupal plus the media module, if you actually go and look at the content structure of the site, you'll see that content types, if I go and manage my fields on media, these right here are media assets built brought in from the media module. So this is something different that I'm doing this demo versus last demo, is last time I used the upload module, whereas this time I'm just strictly using the media module just because I recommend that everyone have a single interface to manage all their media. So that's what that looks like. But anyway, what you end up with, if you want to just like look at your content, so let's say you click on one of these, what you really just get is just the image. You might get, you know, the link right here. Regardless, there's really no media presentation layer here. So what I want to do is actually walk through how you would start. So the very first thing that people might start is say, you know, whenever someone clicks on a node, I want to show the media player. So let me walk you through on how to actually get that to happen. The first thing you're going to want to do is go click on structure and go to MediaFront presets. So MediaFront, the way it works is it works a lot like image cache. So for those of you who are familiar with Drupal 6, excuse me, there's this thing called image cache where you would create presets for how you want to display your image. And whenever I was building MediaFront, I was like, you know, that makes sense. You know, what I want to do is do the same thing that people did for images, but do the same thing but for multimedia. So you're actually going to add a preset for your multimedia. So this one's just going to be called Node Player. The player to show up the node. And then you're going to click next, and the very first thing you see is like a preview of your media player. I could take some time to go through all of these settings, but if you actually click on these settings, you'll see that there's so many ways you can configure this player. All that's really important for you to understand is that when you're doing this, you are changing the presentation of the media player. So really, you're kind of building your own media presentation. And I created like this UI to do that. The two that I use the most is if you go into presentation settings, the first thing I always like to do, in fact, I might default this to be on, which is called fluid width, which what that does is it makes the actual player fit the width of the page, which is really kind of nice because now you don't have to dink with your CSS to kind of make it look pretty. It just kind of fits in whatever container is around it, which is really nice. The next thing that I always typically do is I enable a different template. So the media player that I'm using here is it's also another media player that I built, but I also made it where you could template it, which means you can build a new template for it, which uses the Drupal template system. But the point is you can, out of the box, I provide several templates. The one that I like, and I'm actually building some new ones right now, is just one that's called Simple Black. And so you just go, yeah, that was in the presentation layer, and you just select Simple Black. And you're just gonna hit Save Preset. And so what this is actually gonna do is it looks something like this, which is, it's pretty slick looking. And keep in mind, all of this is HTML. Nothing you see here is Flash. Which is pretty cool. So, I mean, if you think about it, a media player is almost kind of like a website within a website. You know, it has like its own layout and it has all these cool things associated with it. So let's actually make this the node player, the player that shows up in the node. So after I save it, I have my template built. And so the next piece is you notice that didn't do anything to the node. And this is where a lot of disconnect comes from people that use this module. They're like, you know, I created the preset, but it just doesn't do anything. It's like it didn't change any of my media. The point is the preset is where you build the player. The next part is how do you actually connect that to the actual presentation? And for the node presentation, you actually do that within the actual content settings. So you're just going to go to content types, and then you're going to go to media, and you're going to manage fields. Now, Chris, this is going to curl your blood a little bit. Just cover your ears. The point is I'm currently investigating other solutions than this. So what you're about to see is what I consider a hack, but it works until I can figure out something better, which Chris says he's got some pretty good ideas on how you would do this. But for now, what you're going to do is you're just going to create a media player field. And if you look, there's a type called media player, which is a hack. I know it's a hack. Then you're going to save field settings. So that's actually just creating a dummy field. It's not really a field at all. What it's really doing, it's like an aggregator. It's a field that just gobbles up all the rest of the fields in the node and decides what to do with those fields, is really what this is doing. The point is after you've created that, you're going to go to manage display. So after you in manage display, you'll notice that here's your media player field that you created. But the thing that I want to show you is this format. The format allows you just to select the preset. So that's all it is. You build your preset, and the next thing you want to do is you want to add that preset. So all I'm going to do is just drag these guys down to hidden, because I don't want to see those anymore. All I want to see is this media player. I don't want to see a label. And then you just hit save. And that's it. So let's actually click X, and let's watch this thing rebuild. And what you're going to see is, if it'll load, I don't know if this is done.
Yes.
Yeah. It looks like it may have errored out. There we go. It took a while, but there it is. And so here we are. So that it was that easy to actually give a presentation layer. So another really cool thing about this, and a lot of people probably notice, is let me just turn the volume down right here.
If you keep talking, I'm gonna get out of.
If I hover over away from the, you'll see that this is actually YouTube. And what's really cool, let me try to get that the control bar out of the way here, so you can see. Not sure why the control bar. There it goes. So this is actually pulling in from YouTube, but it's doing it without any controls, which, I mean, it looks pretty slick. You got like the shading underneath the player and everything. And so this is typically what you would not see if people are putting YouTube on their site. A lot of times you see YouTube, you see that the basic YouTube player. Well, wouldn't it be cool if you could just show just nothing, and then you could like build your own controls, and you can see these controls control the YouTube player as any normal media player would. So there's really no reason why you can't use YouTube in your website. And the same applies if you just upload just a regular media. So that's the first thing that I wanted to show. The next thing that I want to talk about is playlists and how to show multiple medias on the same page. And to do that, I'm going to direct your attention to the, it brought in everything. I want to direct your attention to the front page where you'll see this. Now, I've noticed a big thing that a lot of people are doing these days is they use like typical HTML drawn views playlists and just add a media player at the top. The view actually controls that media player at the top, which is really cool. So what I want to do right now is I'm going to have just this display, but I'm going to put a media player right there up at the top and have this views control that media player. And I'm going to do this without writing a single line of code. So this will be cool. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a preset. Everything starts with a preset. If you want a new presentation, you start with a preset. So here I'm going to call this the view player. The player to show the view. And then I'm going to hit next. That's going to build this out. And I'm going to do the same thing that I did last time. First thing I'm going to do is change the fluid width, get rid of that. And this time I'm going to keep just this player, but what I do want to do is hide this playlist, because I don't want to show the built-in playlist. I want to use the view to be my playlist. So if you see, just to kind of give you an idea of some of the configurations you can do, you can say playlist settings, and I'm going to go display settings, and I'm going to disable the playlist right there. So now I hit save. And that actually looks like that. So that's fine enough. That's good enough. That took like, what, 1 minute? The next thing I'm going to do is go and edit my, so the next thing I do is not edit my view. What I'm going to do is go to the block section. So the media front module comes pre-built with a special block, as I like to call it. It's just this special block that is built to do exactly what I'm about to show you. which is link a view on the page to that media player. So I'm gonna go to structure, I'm gonna go to blocks, and I'm gonna scroll down until I see something called media player. There it is, media player, and I'm just gonna add him to the content. And I wanna make sure that he's on top. There's a little bug where you have to do that. I don't know what causes that. And then after I do that, I'm gonna configure the media player, and you'll see that there's some media front settings. The first thing that you'll see is that I get to select what preset I wanna use. I wanna use the view player. The next thing is really cool, it's called link to view. So on the page, what this is gonna do is it's going to literally link that player to the view on the page. And so here's the media view, which I have pre-built. And then also you can exclude certain views displays. So if there's a view display that you don't want to link to, which isn't media related, you can put that in here. But for the most part,
when you say display, do you mean like individual display plugins on a single view?
Yes.
Okay, keep going. We'll talk about that later.
Yeah, I figured you'd have something to say about that.
No, I just wanted to see how it works.
Okay, yeah. So there you go. I hit save, and the next thing I'm going to do is close this out. The page is going to reload, and that, here I'm trying to explain it while it's taking forever. Why is it taking so long? And that should have nothing to do with internet connection. That's my virtual box just going really slow. It's probably my screen sharing, hogging resources from my virtual box.
This happens to me sometimes when the update module is trying to ping in 666 usually though. Trying to ping the server and can't get to it.
Does it seem slow when you're saving something or all the time?
When I refresh. Yeah, see it should not take this long. Well, if you want to see what it looks like, I've actually got one built. Media front complete. So this is actually what it looks like. And so what it does is it links itself to the view that was on the page. And so what's really cool is like I can click here and then I can click other media types. And a lot of you are probably wondering, okay, well that's cool, but I'd like to be able to control the playlist from the actual media player. Well, there's actually a special preset or template that does just that. And so if I go to structure and I go to media front presets and go to views player, player settings, presentation settings, there's another template called shock player, which is it was based off a client that basically he funded this feature. And you hit save, and you'll see that this is no different than the simple black, other than it adds these previous and next buttons, which are, so if I just reload that, watch, this is going to take forever. Oh, look at that, service unavailable. That's beautiful. Yeah. So, good thing I already had this built, right? So anyway, this is what's really cool, is you get these on, and it also brings in the titles. So you can do next, and that'll load the next video. And so you literally have your playlist built onto the player, which is pretty slick.
And all the interface is all JavaScript.
Yep, it's all JavaScript. Yep.
I assume that only works for whatever items are on the page.
Yes.
Like it's not working across paging.
That's correct. Yeah, it's not gonna do like pagination automatically for you. Which that's kind of a limitation.
Yeah.
So there's one more thing I want to show you. I don't want to spend too much time talking about it, but it's also how you would change the actual presentation of a certain page. So let's say I don't want to have this support. Man, I'm really, really concerned that's not working anymore. But regardless, I can actually go to this. I'll just use this one. So on this, you'll see it's already doing it. But what I want to show is I could take that one view that showed the grid view, and by just changing the style of the view to a media player, I can show it as a media player. So a great example would be what you just saw, where I actually click the format a media player, And in the settings, I can choose any presets that I want. So in this particular case, I built a preset that had the playlist already, that I didn't get rid of the playlist. I wanted to make sure, I wanted to have the playlist on the actual player. And so then if you actually hit that, this is what you see. It's like the playlist like becomes part of the player, which a lot of websites are doing this, although I would like to say that a lot of websites are moving away from this now. I see it, most people are kind of moving to the whole views approach where you have the grid view. But regardless, when I built this, I kind of wanted this included. One thing that I do see a lot of people ask for is they say, okay, I like the horizontal playlist is okay. What I'd rather have is a horizontal. To show that, I can just go to that one player, and I click edit, and you can go to player settings. Everything that you can think of is exposed to you. Playlist orientation, horizontal. And what this will do is this will slap that playlist horizontally. So like something that would have taken a long time previously is now just there for you. You can just configure everything in this preset and make this media look, get like a really slick media presentation out of it, just right out of the box. One other thing that I do want to describe is you don't have to, in the preset, you don't have to show the actual player. You could do playlist only to where it would essentially work like a carousel. So if you go to structure and you go to media front presets, you'll see that I already created a preset called playlist. If I edit that, you'll see all I did is I went to player settings, playlist settings, display settings, and then I just clicked on playlist only and I hit save, and that was it. Once I have a playlist, and I know a lot of people are like, why would you want to do that? Why would you only want to have the playlist? Well, there's also another big use case that I've had from a lot of my clients where they want to have a playlist like over in the sidebar, and they want to link that to a media player on the homepage where you click this and it basically tells this guy to play, which you could do with the whole view support that I just showed you. So, but again, all of this was built before that view support even existed. But what you can do is something called player-to-player communication, where you can have one preset communicate to another preset. A great example of that is if I go to the media front presets, I created that node player. You guys remember when I created the node player? But now I have this playlist player. Well, let's say I want the playlist preset to control the node player. All you do is you go click and edit, and there's this section called player-to-player where I can literally say, make this preset the playlist for, and you just select another preset. And what that'll do is it'll look for that preset on the page, and it'll just link to it. And so that playlist basically acts as the playlist for that other preset. To show you what this looks like, if I go to content, and I click on, we'll just click on the change up. It does this. So you can literally link a playlist. And so that if I click on this, it'll just load that. And I know that you're saying, well, this is the node page. That kind of doesn't make sense. Obviously, you wouldn't use this on the node page because it doesn't change the rest of the page. It only changes the media player. So that's something, that's one drawback of using this. You would have to do it in a place that makes sense. You don't want to do it on the node page because, you're going to have comments down here and people are changing the video and the comments don't change with it. So it, there is some drawbacks to using that. But regardless, it's pretty cool. And how I did this, I do need to talk about how I did this. This is also in the view where I created a block view. In the block view, you can also choose a media front preset. So that's how I actually brought that playlist over there to the side. So that's it. That's pretty much the guts and glory of the media front module and in what it does. There's so much more. Like I could go and I could talk about what all the settings do on the preset, but I don't think I need to go into all of those. There's a lot of exploratory stuff that you guys can do here. Regardless, what I did want to illustrate is setting up a media presentation without writing a single line of code, without touching your template, without doing anything. All of this is right in front of you so that you guys can get media to your users. Does anybody have any questions before I move on to what's coming for D8? Yep.
The other half of the media module usually is the styles module.
Yep.
Which pretty much sucks.
I was going to say, please let the next word out of your mouth. He sucks.
Yes. But there's a lot of good stuff in there and how it sections off like audio, video, images, and whatnot, and allows you to apply different things. Have you thought about making this integrate better with that as well?
I haven't thought about it, but if you have some ideas that you'd like to go over with me, I'm definitely open to whatever. I mean, you know, this whenever I originally wrote this, I wrote it for Drupal 6, and it was upported to D7. So there's a lot of things in D7 that I have not been able to take advantage of, just because this media front was written for Drupal 6 and then was upported for Drupal 7. And then of course, I kind of like baked in the whole media support, the media module support. So yeah, I'm definitely open if you have any suggestions for implementing styles. So there's just a lot to take in when it comes to media. So any other questions? What do you guys think? You guys, pretty cool? Okay, so I've got about 10 minutes left. What I would like to do now is just kind of go over some of the stuff that I'm currently working on. So my time is kind of split. Actually, it's probably lately it's been more media front and then not so much on the media initiative. But lately I have been spending a lot of time in the media initiative and trying to figure out a good way to present or offer multimedia support out of the box in D8. I am going to give you a little bit of a disclaimer compared to what you just saw in the media front module and all of this type of stuff. It's not going to be as much fireworks involved. My only motivation for Drupal 8 is to simply present media out of the box, to have an option to just display media. So the module that I'm currently developing this in, and you guys can go check this out on your own if you want, or if you use this make file, I bring it in for you. So it's already set up for you if you use the make file. But the actual module is called HTML5 Media. And this is very, very dev, okay? Don't use this in production. It's very, very dev. There's 29 sites using it, but I guarantee it they're not production sites. The point is what I'm trying to build is just this presentation layer. I did have a lot of talks with like Dave Reed and some of the other guys that are involved with media, and you know, they were asking some really good questions as far as like, you know, why are we baking our own? Why can't we just use like Media Element or these other type of media players out there? And my answer to that is simply because those players or those type of presentation layers were not built with content management in mind. They were built simply as standalones. And whenever you build a standalone solution or build it for standalone, you don't take advantage of a lot of the stuff that Drupal has to offer. For example, the template and the theming system of Drupal. One big problem of using these third-party standalone players is that they are really difficult to theme in Drupal, to take over and to control how you want to display them. And so what I'm trying to offer is a very minimalistic, and I think that's the key word here, like the most minimal code I could possibly write to offer this, which works without JavaScript being enabled. So that's the first thing, is that if you have JavaScript disabled, it will try to show video as is using the video elements. If you have JavaScript enabled, what it actually does is it takes over and it has this plugin system to where it has the control bar. You can actually build other players that'll tap into it, like the YouTube player, the Vimeo player. So like if you download the YouTube module in D8, it'll come with the YouTube API JavaScript file that will plug right in to the D8 media player. And so that's kind of my goal, is to make like this pluggable system, but out of the box have it like very minimal, but with the plugin system enabled so that you can just build on top of it with contrib. So let's take a look at it. Like I said, HTML5 media. And what you want to do there is we're going to start with the actual content types. And what I did is I created if you guys build the make, you'll see that I built this for you, a HTML5 media type, which already utilizes the HTML5 media. So all of this goes with manage fields. So if you click on manage fields, what you'll see is I created a media upload which uses file field. So that's the thing. I implemented this and tapped this into the file field. And so you'll just say file field and you use the file widget. And inside the widget, so if I actually click on the settings, you'll see that I allowed these files extensions. You can allow even more. As of this weekend, I got Flash fallback working, so you can use FLVs, you can use whatever. So, I mean, there's a lot of formats that Flash supports. And so if you're trying to present a file that the browser doesn't support, Flash fallback works now. And where I really want to direct your attention is the displays, the managed display. And so this is where the actual HTML5 stuff comes into play, which uses the field formatters. And so you can say a format is video. I'm contemplating making a single formatter called media, which is kind of what the media module does. But I'm currently having talks with Dave Reed about that right now, and he likes to have them separated. But anyway, video, and then if you want to go, and then to basically configure the media player, so this is going to be like the D8 version of a media front preset, is actually built into the field. So you have these formatter field settings where you can select what template you want to use. You can do like the video presets. You can provide the width and height to your player. And this is all directly tapped into the actual HTML. And then once you do that, currently there's only one template that I've built for this. Once you do that, you can actually go and add a content. So let me go and say I want to add HTML5 media. I'm just gonna use movie trailers like I normally do. So I'm gonna choose and upload, and this is the image, right? So I'm gonna submit that. There's that, and now here's the actual. I'm gonna upload that. There we go. And you hit save. I do one thing I do want to mention is I don't have any loaders currently, and there is kind of like an auto load problem that I'm currently working on. But if you refresh the page, which I'm currently working on, this is what you're presented with. One thing you'll notice here is that this player will look the same in every single browser. So this is the default template that I built for HTML5 media, and this is actually built using this control bar is HTML. So cool thing about that is you can theme it. Another thing that's different than MediaFront is out of the box I use jQuery UI to do the stuff like the scroll bar, to do all, you know, I'm using tools that are already present in Drupal 8 or Drupal 7 to offer to basically build this control bar. So now, whenever going back to this whole control bar, this whole plugin concept, the way that I actually built this player was object oriented, where everything is a plugin, including the control bar, including the actual player. So what you can do is you can literally provide your own control bars in a contrib module, and it'll tap right in and it'll enable, and you can suddenly have access to the actual media object. Another great thing about this is you now suddenly have JavaScript access to what's going on with your video. So you can track what users are watching, you can track where they are in the video, just by some very simple JavaScript you can do that using this media player. Another cool thing is that this also provides support for YouTube and Vimeo version out of Contrib. So like the Contrib Vimeo module will offer this YouTube plugin display, and that'll just tap right in. So if anybody tries to show multimedia that comes from YouTube, the YouTube plugin will say, I can show that, and he raises his hand, and the plugin manager basically says, okay, and he makes him come in and basically handle the display of the media. So I know that this isn't like fantastic, but this is pretty much what's going to happen. This is what you're going to get. You're not going to get the whole plugin and like view support, because really all of that is Contrib, and that belongs in Contrib. All that really that Drupal 8 needs is an out of the box way to present media. And so that's what I'm actually building right now. And so, I mean, it's a really pretty player. I mean, the you can see the control bar. It resizes if it goes into full browser mode. I'm currently working on full screen, which some browsers now support full screen, so it'll actually show the whole video. And this also does flash fallback. So, I built a flash player that's nothing but a black square with JavaScript API, and that's all it is. And so what I do is if you can't play it, I slap in that Flash player with this JavaScript API, and the JavaScript communicates to it just like it communicates to the HTML5 player, and everything is kosher. So that's it.